Accounting policy for inventories of Alpha Enterprises states that inventories are valued at the lower of cost, determined on FIFO basis or net realizable value. Which accounting principle is followed in adopting the above policy? A. Materiality, B. Prudence, C. Substance over form, and D. All of the above. Lower of cost or net realizable value. Therefore, we are talking of prudence. Prudence. The correct answer should be prudence. Next, selection of an inappropriate accounting policy decision may A. overstate the performance and financial position of a business entity. B. understate or overstate the performance and financial position of a business entity. C. overstate the performance of a business entity. D. understate the financial position of a business entity. B. The answer should be we understate or overstate the performance and financial position of a business entity. As per Accounting Standard 1, disclosure should form a part of disclosure of accounting policies that should form a part of A. financial statements, B. the auditor's report, C. the director's report, and D. the books of accounts. Disclosure of accounting policies should form part of the financial statements. Correct answer is A. Which is not an example of an accounting policy? A. Going concern. B. Valuation of fixed assets. C. Treatment of retirement benefits. And D. Valuation of inventories. The correct answer is going concern. Not an example of an accounting policy. Valuation of fixed things. There may be a policy. Do you value it at historical cost? Do you value it at market value? Treatment of retirement benefits. There might be a policy on how retirement benefits are to be accounted for. Valuation of inventory is a policy. You may have 3-4 methods. You adopt one that suits you. But going concern is a basic accounting concept which assumes that the business is going to exist for a long period of time. That is not an accounting policy. Correct answer. Next, a change in accounting policy is justified to comply with accounting standard, B. comply with law, C. ensure more appropriate presentation of financial statements, D. all of the above. We've done this several times now. Change in accounting policy is justified for all of the above. To comply with the law, to comply with an accounting standard, and to ensure a better presentation of the financial standards. Which of the following is not an example of change in accounting policy? A. Change in method of providing depreciation on fixed assets. B. Change in method of providing inventory valuation. C. Adopting double entry system of accounting in place of single entry. D. Change in method of valuation of investments. Not an example of a change in accounting policy. This is change, this is change. Valuation of investments is also change. But if you adopt a double entry system instead of accounting in place of single entry, that's not really a change in accounting policy. We should have, this is how accounts should actually be maintained in order for people to understand your financial statement. Single entry is no system at all. So double entry is a basic dual concept, not an accounting policy. Correct answer, C.